Rahman Rahim Hala. I am the doctoral student Benfatah Ahmed at the University of Media. Within the framework of international conferences, I have the honor to present my work entitled High Performance Photovoltaic Generation System Connected to the Network Based on the ZSource Apps. Work plan. First of all, we will start with on introduction, then we will see global system. The third part will be consecrated for the simulation and discussion of the results obtained. And finally, we will end with a conclusion. Introduction. ZSource topology is a competitive alternative to current conventional PV-PC systems, due to its unique advantage of firing, voltage, or boost capabilities. In addition, the power loss is reduced due to the reduced number of switching devices. The ZSource, the ZSI inverter in the proposed system has two independent control variables, fire throw action and modulation indicator. The reinforcement control strategy is quite similar to the traditional PWM control method. This figure represents source inverter based photovoltaic power conversion system containing a PV with a ZSource inverter connected to the grid with a MPPT system applied to track the maximum value. A real-time PV panel is realized in a MATLAB environment by modeling PV system using its fundamental equations. An equivalent circuit relates the PV system with its fundamental equations. The inference from the output curves of the PV model is that PV curve has a peak power relevant to a particular voltage, and it's essential to operate the PV panel at that voltage, say VMPP, to make operate the PV system to deliver its maximum power for the given ambient temperature and irradiation. A typical solar panel converts only 28 to 40% of the incident solar radiation into electrical energy. In this technique of tracking, the maximum power point is used to improve the efficiency of the solar module. In the characteristics of PV, there is a point called MPP, maximum power point, which always occurs on the knee of the curve where the generated PV power is maximized as shown in figure. The algorithm selection depends on the complexity of time and reliability. The algorithm is taken to track MPP implementation cost and ease of implementation P and L. Inverter is connected in parallel with ZSource network. The ZSource network consists of two inductors, L1 and L2, connected at the ends of pair of cross-connected capacitors, C1, C2. ZSI operates in two modes, shoot-through mode and no shoot-through mode. In ZSI, the main switching criteria is to obtain a shoot-through for boosting of the DC voltage. The switching sequence is as follows. Two straight lines are used as upper and lower shoot through. Reference lines DP and VM, respectively, as shown in figure. Whenever the triangular waveform is greater than VP, all the upper switching devices of the inverter are switched on, whereas the lower devices are already on, causing shoot through. Similarly, shoot through occurs by turning the lower switches on whenever the line VN is greater than the triangular waveform. In this control method, the shoot through duty ratio decreases with increase in M modulation index. In shoot through mode, the inductors charge while the capacitors discharge, thus achieving an increased DC voltage as input to the inverter. During this mode, no energy will be fed to the load. Typical solar panels have MPP strength, voltage, and current levels. With the ZSI design to follow, the Z source network parameters are designed and shown in the table. The purpose of the simulation system is to track the maximum available power from the PV array when the solar energy is varied and the extracted energy is output to the grid at 500 AC lines, because VDCRF equals 500 volts shown in waveforms. In the simulation, the solar irradiance varies between 3 radiation levels, 500 watts per meter squared, 750 watts per meter squared, 1000 watts per meter squared, and the specified MPPT. The algorithm successfully tracked the maximum available photoelectric force by changing the fire in action. The modification was that the control system was able to maintain peak DC voltage, where we have the value of the network voltage for one phase, 220 volts, which is the required value, because the value of phase-to-phase voltage of grid is 220 volts. Finally, conclusion. In conclusion, this paper presented the integration with the conventional MPPT algorithm based on the switching pattern of the Z source inverter with enhanced firing effect. This controller realizes both states during changing and sudden change of radiation, as it can regulate capacitor voltage and the impedance source to be maintained continuously. The proposed system achieves boost and reflection with maximum power tracking in a single power phase, thus reducing the number of switching devices. Thanks for your attention.